Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Altel Stadium. The events of September 11th have changed the world. Let us take a moment to remember and move forward together in a new spirit of unity and determination.
For the National Football League and all Americans, last Sunday was a day of grieving, a day of mourning, a day of healing. It was not a time to play football. It was a time to lend a hand and give a hug. It was a day when our football heroes paid tribute to other heroes. Now, with a new sense of purpose, it is time to return to work and play, to open our stadiums and move forward, to return to football and everything else that America stands for, to take our first step together with dedication and determination, while never forgetting where we've been and where we need to go.
Now, please stand and join together in a moment of silence for the victims of September 11th. Thank you. Your attention is directed to the field, where a color guard from Blunt Island Command is joined by Sarah Croft, a 16-year-old high school student, for the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets a red glare, the bombs bursting
Jaguars, right after this. Altel Stadium, Jacksonville, Florida. We are set to renew one of the great rivalries in the National Football League as the Titans take on the Jaguars. The weather today, sunny now, 84 degrees, but rain expected later. And as a symbol of our country beginning its recovery process, President Bush has ordered all flags raised to full staff. Although our nation is wounded, we move forward. Hi, everybody. I'm Gus Johnson, joined by my partners Sam Weish and Brent Jones. All right, Jeff Fisher, the head coach of the Tennessee Titans, coming off back-to-back 13-3 seasons. However, a disappointing loss 2 weeks ago to Miami in their season opener. They lost the game at home. On the other sideline, Tom Coughlin has led the Jaguars to 2 AFC Central Division titles. And Coach Coughlin's team defeating the Pittsburgh Steelers here on opening day 21-3. The Jaguars and Titans have split the 12 regular season games in this series. Every game in the series, except for 2, have been decided by 8 or fewer points. And we are ready. Tennessee has won the toss and will receive the football. Jim Tarl, the kickoff specialist. And we're underway from Jacksonville. From the 15-yard line, Derek Mason. Mason leaps forward, gets to the 30, a return of 14 yards. Free safety, he's going to have to make all the calls this afternoon with Donovan Darius out of the lineup because of a hip injury. Here's Eddie George running, hurtling. George breaks it down and gets close to the 30-yard line. And a look at the Tennessee scoring drive. 9 plays, 41 yards. They ate up 4 minutes. The 22-yard field goal for Nedney. And on the drive, Eddie George, 5 carries, 23 yards. First down from the 20. McCardell in motion. Brunell, quick drop. Smith on the slant with the catch. Jimmy Smith, first down at the 33, a gain of 13. Joe Walker making the tackle.
Watch where the ball lands right here. Now, Jimmy Smith coming to start against Samari Rowe right here. When he goes to the inside, watch where the ball is thrown. Into the body. The quarterback is taught, throw that ball into the body. Almost act like the arms extend from the elbows out. That way you don't stretch that receiver out and get him killed in the middle of the field.
Yeah, I wish you would have told Steve Young that when I played.
First and 10 from the 33. Play action. Brunell setting up deep underneath Jimmy Smith. Another great grab inside Tennessee territory. Gain of 19, Blaine Bishop with the tackle. Is this guy good or what?
He is great. In fact, Samari Rowe told us he's the best receiver in the National Football League.
And we were talking about Jimmy Smith. He didn't expect to see Samari Rowe on him today. He just thought in a few instances, maybe a nickel. But we talked to Samari Rowe last night, and he said, I'm going to be with him most of the day. Little wrinkle for this Titans defense.
Big challenge for the fourth-year player out of Florida State. Here's the screen. Set up nicely. Brunell gets it away to Fred Taylor. Taylor, great running after the catch. Gets to the 35-yard line. A gain of 11. Samari Rowe with the stop. First down, Jacksonville.
When you play against Fred Taylor, you've got to make that first tackle. Watch Eddie Robinson, number 55, right here. He's going to have a crack at him. He reads screen right away, goes through the blockers, and you see Fred Taylor change direction, and there's Eddie just not able to wrap up. And you turn Fred Taylor loose into your secondary and bat.
Very nice, the Furman graduate here. Second down and 2 from the 28. Fred Taylor around the corner. Taylor cuts. Taken down at the
looking for that shot coming in today.
Third down at 7 from the 17. They need to go to the 10 for first down. Mark Brunell out of the shotgun. Here's Brunell looking instantly. Threw that one a little bit high. Intended receiver Keenan McCardell, and he got pummeled.
And Mark
Donald
Brunell.
Mitchell hitting it.
Trying to work it in.
Brings on Mike Hollis to attempt a 35-yarder. Has hit 17 straight field goals against the Houston, Tennessee franchise. Make it 18 straight. All advice, including updated injury reports and depth charts, at cbs.sportsline.com or AOL. Keyword, CBS Sportsline.
I'm always on there looking for fantasy advice.
I know.
You know who my pick is?
Who's your pick?
Jimmy Smith is my guy
Jimmy
for the last
Smith.
Couple years.
You would pick Jimmy Smith.
He's made me a lot of... Andy Bars.
You Palmer.
No, it's just the truth.
Second down at 8 from the 26. Out of the shotgun, Brunell. Stepping up under pressure. Brunell got good wheels. He slides down at the 33-yard line. Blaine Bishop getting to a first. Blaine Bishop may be called for a penalty. flag on the play coming late.
It's to protect the quarterback. It's a rule, and there are a lot of rules that are in just to protect that one player. He's too important to the game.
Yeah, and what you said, Coach, is right. I mean, it's tough once you're in that position as a defensive player. Blaine Bishop, obviously not happy about that, but you got to protect the quarterbacks. And as a defensive player, you have to know that.
So a 15-yard penalty gets Jacksonville up to the 48. Inside handoff. Great move, get to the 40, but fumble. Is he down? That's the question. And they say it is a fumble. Tennessee picks up the football.
And Fred Taylor took a great shot right in the stomach region, and I think he dropped the ball from that shot. And you see him holding his stomach.
So Taylor is down. 12:06 to go. Game tied at 3. Back in a moment. Welcome back to Altel Stadium. Fred Taylor still on the field. And he has to be helped up. 6 carries, 24 yards, but he's in a lot of pain.
And Gus, it's rare that you have so much pain that you just stop and drop the ball. He doesn't get hit. You're going to see him make this move right there. And obviously, he pulls either a groin or a stomach muscle, and he just goes right down. And let's go of the ball. After that move right there wasn't touched, and you see him just go and drop. And as potent as this Jacksonville offense has seemed, they lose a tremendous amount with Fred Taylor, who hasn't been able to play a 16-game season his whole career.
And it'll go Stacy Mack, who's only started 2 games last year. He's an undrafted rookie in 99. He only wanted to make the ball club.
So Mack will replace him when the Jaguars get the ball back. And Fred Taylor, he missed 6 games in 1999 with a hamstring. Missed 3.5 last year with a strained MCL. Has been criticized in the past for being unable to stay healthy.
And you even asked him about that yesterday, and he seemed to get a little
kind of snapped.
Yeah, he snapped
my head off there a little bit.
And he's a good man, but I guess he's tired of hearing that question.
Clark, 89 offense, 5-yard penalty, still first.
And so he obviously a little sensitive to the injury question, but it continues to hamper Fred and this Jaguar team. And this is a different team without Fred Taylor in the backfield.
And Coach, that's what the Jaguars talked about yesterday when we spoke with them. They returned 16 starters from their 99 AFC Championship team. However, they're very, very thin after those guys.